identify myself being a Mexican American, but more Mexican than American. I do a lot more Mexican stuff. I don't celebrate the 4th of July, but I celebrate Cinco de Mayo.
Me casé y mi esposo vivía aquí y fue por eso que me vine a vivir para acá, pero fue por esa razón que yo me vine para acá, pero mi pensamiento no estaba venir a vivir acá.
El mayor obstáculo ha sido el idioma y acostumbrarte o entrar al sistema.
I don't know, 'cause over here it's big and it's like you just look at somebody ugly and they automatically have stuff against you.
El ritmo de vida, la calidad de vida, el idioma. De hecho, el sistema de trabajar es muy diferente al que usamos en México.
Sí, para mí fue bien difícil porque era todo bien diferente.
My life here in the U.S., it's nothing but staying home and going to school.
La vida del inmigrante en los Estados Unidos es trabajar, trabajar y trabajar.
When I'm home, I usually it depends on what mom wants me to do. Like, sometimes she tells me to broom and mop, wash dishes, clean the bathroom, clean my room, vacuum. I go to Mexico a lot because, my mom's family is over there and, half of my dad's or something.
Down there, it's fun and, you get to see the family. I get to, kick it with my cousins, talk to them and see my grandparents.
Almost every time we go, there's always a party. And over there, it's everyone knows everybody. And everything's nearby. It's walking distance.
La diferencia entre la vida de Estados Unidos y el México es que en México tienen un poquito más de libertad.
La diferencia es que Samantha, cuando va para México, allá no tiene ninguna obligación.
One day at Mexico, it's a whole year over here. Everything happens. I wake up, I eat breakfast with my family, and then I just leave.
Su forma de actuar cuando no está con nosotros. O sea, delante de nosotros sigue siendo la misma niña, pero cuando anda así con sus amigas o con sus amigos, se nota que ya está evolucionando un poquito más.
My life at Mexico, it's fun. I'm never home. I'm always with friends, cousins, and aunties and uncles. So when I go over there, I have no parents. I have freedom over there, but not over here. I have way more freedom over there, a lot more.
Una tradición mexicana que hemos celebrado la mayoría de los hispanos, tenemos el celebrar los 15 años de nuestras hijas para el cambio de niñas a mujer.
Primero, el bautizo. Después, la confirmación. Luego, la primera comunión. Luego, los 15 años y por último, las bodas.
I decided to do it over there because I have way more family over there.
It's the gathering of family, uncles, aunts, cousins that we haven't seen for a while from, my dad's side of the family, from Mexicali, from Washington, my mom's family that we don't go visit them that often.
Decidimos hacer la fiesta de 15 años Samantha en México porque la mayoría de la familia de ella vive en México. O sea, hay una parte de la familia que no puede viajar de México a Estados Unidos. Y una de las personas más importantes es su abuelita por parte de su mamá.
We started preparing for the quinceañera on January when we came back from another one.
Yo en lo personal quiero que sea algo muy inolvidable para ella.
Vamos a tratar de darle lo que nosotros podemos, de tenerle su fiesta más o menos como ella lo ha pedido, a darle gusto porque es su fiesta.
Estuvo ahorrando dinero por muchos años para tener todo listo para esta fiesta.
My dad, he went over there. He found the church and the hall. And then in April for spring break, I went over there and I talked to four different ladies about my dress and they didn't understand it until one lady, she understood it. So I got the medidas and all that.
I think I have been involved, but at the same time I haven't. Cause we're right here in Altadena and my mom has to go all the way out to Ensenada and fix things up, and I haven't been there for a while, so she just comes and, talks about it, and I'm like, oh, well, won't you do this, won't you do that, I give her advice.
We had to pick up my dress, and my mom's dress, and some of my dama's dresses, and then I went to the hair and makeup. and I got out like a 3. First I took pictures at home and then at the beach. Then we went to the mass. And after mass, I took pictures from in. And then we went to the hall. And yeah, we just partied. And then the next day, we still partied. We had a piñata and tacos and a jumper. It was like all family and like the chambelanes and damas, just to like thank them and stuff, you know, for showing up.
Pues yo pienso que lo mejor que ha sido nuestra familia es que pues que nos hemos querido y que hemos estado siempre juntos y que se han portado bien, que han sido buenas personas, buenos niños.
Pues eso, que es familia, que es mi familia, que tratamos de ser una familia bien unida, que tenemos una buena relación, que tenemos buena comunicación.
We tell each other everything and we're always bonding together. Ever since we were small, we would go out to places together and some families don't do that.
We just can't keep stuff from each other. It's like we tell each other everything, kind of like.
Ahora ya se arregla diferente. Antes yo la arreglaba como yo quería, le ponía la ropa que yo quería. Ahora ya es decisión de ella, ya se peina diferente.
Samantha's just Samantha. She's just free-spirited, I guess. She doesn't really care what you have to say about her. She's just her own person.
Es una niña muy dulce, muy amorosa. Tiene una chispa especial, es muy alegre.
I guess live her life to the fullest. I mean, you only get one chance to live, so I mean, if you're gonna do something, you know, do it right there in that moment. I don't want her to be, you know, be like 35 or 40 years old and regret some decisions that she made.
Primeramente no haga las cosas porque la gente se lo pide, sino que porque ella lo quiere hacer así y para bien de ella y por su felicidad.